was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight. My monster from his...
It's Girl T.I.E here, which stands for Together Individual Entertainment, T.I.E. All right, in honor of Dancing with the Stars double Disney night, we are going to get into the 5-minute Halloween stories of Disney. Because, for what I understand, normally Dancing with the Stars would hold a one-night Disney night. But instead, they are going to do a double Disney night, which means it's a two-night event for Disney. One night it's going to be regular songs from Disney, and the other night is going to be Disney Villain Night. And it's all because of course, the 50th anniversary of Disney World, and, of course, the celebration of Halloween. So, basically, we're getting into Halloween / 50th anniversary on Dancing with the Stars. So, let's get into our first story. And I have to tell you guys, I will not be doing all these stories because most of these stories I've already done last year in a different collection. But still, I'm pretty excited to get into another Disney book story. This time, it's Halloween related. So, let's get into it, shall we? And our first story will be... The Princess and the Frog, Tina's Ghost. Halloween New Orleans began with a rusty orange sunset. "That sun looks just like a big old pumpkin," Tina said, standing in the doorway of her restaurant. "It's perfect for Halloween." Her friend was Charlotte, said Flouncy, up in a little Bo Peep costume. "And look, those mini fat clouds look just like your baguettes." Tina scolded. "What, brown sugar?" Charlotte asked. "Don't you love Halloween?"
"I do," Tiana said. "It's just, there's been some weird stuff going on today. You reminded me about when you mentioned baguettes."
"Where baguettes still?" Charlotte asked, laughed at her. "Only you would have a pastry mystery Halloween, Tina." Tina shook her head. "It's probably nothing. I made a special batch of them for Halloween party tonight.
And they've all gone missing," Charlotte smiled. "You know, they said the spirits walk the earth on Halloween. Maybe they're the ones causing this mischief," she teased. Tiana laughed, but she wondered if maybe Charlotte was right.
Tiana knew spirits were real. She had seen them during her adventure as a frog. "I'm sure. Hope it's not ghosts," she thought nervously. Just then, something fluttered at the edge of her vision. But when she spun around, nothing was there.
"Did you see that?" Tiana said.
"See what?" Charlotte asked.
"Tiana, honey, get in your hat and let's go. We have a pumpkin to carve, apples to bubble, and pie to throw."
Tiana smiled, shrugged off her nerves.
"Okay, okay," she said. "I'm ready.
First, Tiana and Charlotte went to the Halloween fest at the farmer's market to carve pumpkin. But just as Tiana was putting the finishing touches on their pumpkin, she saw something strange out of the corner of her eye.
"What was that?" Charlotte said, dropping her pumpkin, but it was already gone.
"You saw it too?" Tiana asked.
"I saw something," Charlotte said. She looked a little spooked.
Next, the friends went bobbing for apples, but Tiana came up from the air. She saw Charlotte shrieked.
"She saw it too."
The little wisp white was gone as quickly as she appeared. Tiana and Charlotte stared at each other.
"I'm pretty sure you're being haunted, sweetie," Charlotte and Tiana told.
As Tiana and Charlotte walked back to the restaurant, Tiana kept peering over her shoulder. She couldn't shake the feeling that there was something following her, but it always disappeared before she could get a good look. Tiana did her best to ignore the flutters as she settled into her restaurant kitchen. She needed to work on the finishing touches for her big
Halloween party. The first step was to replace those missing baguettes. And of course, Tiana was just sprinkling powdered sugar over the fresh baguettes when the lights in the kitchen flickered and went out. Crashes and shouts of surprise sounded from every direction as Tiana sat blundering into each other in the dark. Tiana clutched her basket baguettes tightly. Her heartbeat thundered in her ears. Swish! Something brushed her hand. As suddenly as the lights had gone on, they came back on again. Tiana, what on earth? Charlotte cried, running into the kitchen. Is everyone all right? Tiana asked, looking around. Her staff all nodded shakily. There was no sign of whatever had touched her hand, but several of the baguettes were missing. Tiana had just about had enough. Why is this ghost haunting me? She asked Charlotte. New Orleans is full of people. What's so special about me? Well, Charlotte said thoughtfully, you do make the best beignet in all of New Orleans. Maybe the ghost is just hungry. There's only one way to find out, Tiana said. She rolled up her sleeves and got to work on the biggest, tastiest batch of beignets she ever made. As soon as the beignets were done, Tiana and Charlotte left the treats in the basket at the restaurant kitchen back door. Then they snuck around the corner to watch. They waited and waited. Just as they were about to give up, there was a movement in the shadows. Tiana and Charlotte clutched each other's hands. Tiana's heart was beating so hard, she could feel it in her toes. She never been so spooked. The ghost moved into the light. Tiana let out a big sigh of relief, and then she started laughing. The ghost was just a bunch of kids. Tiana stepped out of her hiding place. Surprise, kids! Sorry, Miss Tiana, one of them said nervously. Trick or treat! Said the other one. We're just really, really hungry, said a third. Well, then come on, Tiana said, smiling. I've got a big Halloween party going, and you're all invited. Really? The first kid asked, her eyes widened. Sure, Tiana said. After all, a chicken is good, deserves a treat. All right. Can't wait to get into the next story of the 5-minute Halloween stories of Disney. Well, I hope you enjoyed that Disney Halloween. Oh, and if you're wondering where our safety thing's going to be, don't worry. I've got a special surprise for you today, and I cannot wait to post it when I do. In the meantime, this is Ty saying, get ready for your surprise. Bye! Surprise! It's Kennywood, everyone! And if you forget, it's me, Ty, and we're standing for Together Individual Entertainment, T.I.E. So, I am back at Kennywood again, but this time, I'm here during the Halloween season! And as you can tell, it's daytime, and even though the scary music is going on, it's not scary during the daytime. Why is that? Oh, look at that. Funny. Because what they have here is daytime family fun Halloween. And we're going to make sure we have a lot of fun here today. Now basically, what this is supposed to be is a graveyard. It's supposed to be trick-or-treating in the graveyard or whatever. But things have changed. Like for what I thought was going to happen, luckily not. It happened like the hayride near the end, as you can tell, it rained and stuff. But anyways, as you know, it's Safety Saturday once again. So let's get into it. So, as you can tell, we're looking at the roads and everything, make sure everything is clear. That's one thing you should look at your driveway and for your driveways, make sure the leaves and everything are raked or like swept off your pavement stones or whatever, because here's the thing.
when it rains and it pours, pretty much got slippery leaves. You don't need these kids falling on their bums, or you don't need them getting hurt. So make sure that you rake and sweep all leaves out of your driveway or your sidewalks or something. That way the kids are safe and they're not gonna get hurt. The other thing is, if you haven't noticed, it rained because of the wet ground. And basically, that's one thing you should always recommend. I'm gonna try and turn my camera around or something. Or I can't. Anyways, the thing, what I'm trying to say is, you see this? I've got long sleeves on. And I got a hoodie. You might as well know this. Check the weather before you go out anywhere. Because here's the thing. If you're out into trick-or-treating or something like that, then you know you've got to be prepared for the weather. Like cold weather, you gotta wear long sleeves. That's another thing. Make sure you have long sleeves underneath your kid's costume. You also want to make sure that you also have an umbrella, poncho, or something when it comes to the rain season. So this is one of the scare areas during the nighttime, which I'm not saying for. I'm not saying at all. Like an old piano. I have no idea where they got the old piano, but definitely that's very retro. This is pretty cool how they got the old retro theme and everything in between. But like I said, oh, there's one rule that I shouldn't mention to you. So the one rule that Kennywood has decided to put in finally is that here at Kennywood Park, there's absolutely no one, and I mean no one, under the age of 18 is allowed to come here without a grown-up. I mean, that's pretty simple to remember. But I'm pretty excited to see what else goes on about here. Another skeleton. I find this hilarious, you guys. I do. Now, basically, as you can tell, I'm roaming by myself in Kennywood, but when it comes to little kids and everything, here's one thing that you should know. Stay in a group. You should always remember to stay in a group. Look at that. Zoom in. All the water is gone from the Pittsburgh Plunge. Things are not open yet because it may be noon where the park is open now, but I do not know when everything is open. See, all the water is gone. That's because it's fall and they do not need the water to be frozen. And most of the rides are already taken out for the season, like the swings and thing, but we're just gonna walk around. Now this is one of the scare places right here during the nighttime as well. Here in the Lost Kennywood, that's what they call it, is practically scare everything. And as always, there's a warning. They do not touch the actors, they will not touch you, which is a good thing. Because that's practically a rule about scare. You cannot touch people. And basically, I'm not scared, and I don't want to be, but we're just going to walk around. Hmm.
I felt bad that they had to do that.
And come on, be nice to the animals while I'm done.
They got rotten pumpkins over there. Let's see.
Believe me, this is one of the scare zones that was gonna happen.
Now, I did not see any other scares. Now, I remembered when I first worked here in 2014, they had a lot more going on for, you know, the scares and everything. But because of COVID, they shrunk it down some. So. Now, if you're wondering about the Christmas season, I've got some good news for you guys. Christmas season, yes. Christmas season is happening. Unfortunately, I do not know when tickets go on sale for Christmas, but you'll just have to be patient about that. I already smelled the potato patch fries. I don't know why, but that's not potato patch. I'm just letting you know. Even though they have fries everywhere, there's just a certain kind of potato patch fries that everybody loves. When you're a Pittsburgher like me, even though I don't live in Pittsburgh, you kind of eat stuff that you don't normally eat in another town or another state. Like, for example, our Pittsburgh famous fries here at Kennywood is the potato patch fries, which is pretty famous here at Kennywood. And the other thing that's famous is basically, I guess you could say a salad with fries. Yeah, when it's theme park, we got fries, egg, chicken, lettuce, all those type of things in a salad that happen. I mean, not a lot is going on right now because they just opened up, but we're just gonna have to be patient about that. So I will get back into recording as soon as I can. For now, I cannot wait to have fun at this most amazing thing. However, there is one part of Kennywood that I wanna show. Oh, and there goes the Phantom. That's the Phantom's Revenge, people. And through the steel curtain, it is done. Like, done. It's not going away or nothing. It's just that it's done for the season. That's all. Now, this is the Thunderbolt King of the Coasters. And as you can tell, they decorated it with skeletons and everything. And what they even brought back, which they did not have during the summertime, but we are so happy that he has returned, is the, oh no. Okay, so look at this. They've already got the Christmas lights set up, but you can't, here. See them now? They got the Christmas lights set up already, even though it's, you know, just beginning October. But this is the Ghostwood Estate. And this is a game ride that you use lasers on. So they returned the lasers this season in honor of the, Halloween. Now, as for the Raging Rapids, they completely made it dry and everything, and now it is called the Voodoo Bayou. It is a haunting that you guys can go into at night. However, like I said, it is, you know, It's not a scare zone. But like, as a reminder, you guys, I'm letting you guys know this. No one under the age of 18 is allowed to come in here without an adult. So you need a chaperone. And I'm serious, you need a chaperone to make this work. Just remember that, all right? So if you are 18 and older, you can come in here without a chaperone. If you are 18 and under, you need a chaperone. So please try to remind that. Oh, look at this, it's so cute. They got a little trick-or-treat in it. Oh my God, the decor is so cute. And here's a little photo booth, which I'm walking up to. This is so cute. I like how they just had a little photo booth and everything right here. But I'm gonna stop it right here and I'll record as much as I can later on.